Okay, our briefing will cover all this in the index. There are 13, but I'm not going to explain all because I already attached the slide in this briefing, EWOW briefing. You can refer to it. Okay, this is what finance unit is doing, taking care of your payment, yeah, payment for tuition fee, hostel, registration, and also penalty that we want to avoid. And then also we are also managing student outstanding balance and also debts. Outstanding balance mean whatever you owe to the university. And then we also this one, the third one, clearance slip, is seldom seldom being used or seldom being used by student nowadays, because normally because now most of our student at their place, only sem one and sem final sem student in the campus. Okay, we are doing the work of refunding to students who are graduating, or some student that have to leave UDK ELMIMED early because of non-performance. And then on the last one is on the consultation. Consultation and deferment of payment, surat aku janji. If you this also seldom happen, it will happen if you have a subject that you need to repeat, if you those who receive PTPTN, yes, PTPTN, receive funding from PTPTN, this also will be used. For MARA, I think MARA will pay based on your entitlement lah. So if you have the receive 100% tuition fee sponsorship from MARA, then you will not need to fill in the surat aku janji. Surat aku janji means letter of undertaking, something like that. Letter that mean you promise to the university that you are going to pay within certain certain period. Okay. Okay, let's see the okay, next slide is registration fee, tuition fee and hostel fee. Okay, you can refer to buku panduan pendaftaran. I think this has been attached to your portal, is it, Cik Shaful? In your portal, you can refer to that. Okay, fee differ between. Okay, this is for your information. Fees differ between cohorts. Cohorts mean semester. Cohorts means because UniKL, we every 3 years, every 5 years, we need to do curriculum review. So every time during the curriculum review, there's a changes in your the subject that you need to learn. So different intake will learn different subject lah. I mean subject, the same subject, but the content of the subject is different. Okay, so that's why there is the fee difference between cohorts or intake. Okay, so that you can also refer to buku panduan pendaftaran in your student portal. Okay, next. Okay, how to use student portal? This is how to use it. You go to your student portal, then click at the My Info, and then next to My Ledger, and you will see all this invoices that has been raised by finance. Yeah. So this invoice normally when macam you all ni, first sem student, you all tak nampak lah macam ni. Yeah. Or this the listed, the list of all the invoices. Yeah. From the day, I mean from sem one until habis lah kan? Until until ni lah outstanding, all the outstanding. So so kalau you all buat payment, if you made any payment in your student ledger, you cannot see. Yeah, this is only for the invoice generating the invoices that has been generated. Yeah. By finance, so payment will not be seen here. Okay, okay, okay. Next, okay. If you use mobile app, okay, what you have to do is you just click at financial ni. Okay, kat sini saja you click, then straight away you can see your how much the outstanding fee. Yeah, if you have outstanding fee, you can, if you want to inquire about outstanding fee, you can call finance department atau finance unit and also email. I'm going to give you the list of contact number at the end of the apa briefing. Okay. So next, okay, you just bear with me for about 30 minutes lah ya. Bear with madam ya, sebab this is going to be quite boring. And then you know I cannot see you face to face, so if I can see you face to face, it will be more, you know, ni lah seronok sikit lah. Yeah, boleh bergurau-gurau dengan you all ni. Ha, tapi kat sini rasa macam, you know, I have to rush for the presentation, yeah, for the briefing. Okay, and then this is how fee computation, charge yuran pengajian mengikut jam kredit. Okay. Okay, let me explain about apa ni. TCG means total credit to graduate. Yeah, that means your study, your fee tu, for example for BMO, I think the fee is 56,000. Cik Shaful, yeah. Because actually I'm with Cik Shaful, the other head of unit of finance. You will be meeting him later on. Cik Shaful is also in charge of finance. He is the head of unit. So total credit to graduate is based on apa? Your fee is based on total credit to graduate. Okay, for example, if your fee is 56,000 for BMO, BMO student. So there are subjects that apa ni dia that we call unique L subject. Yeah, dia punya depan coding dia is, if I'm not mistaken, W something like that lah. So W, and then that will cost you not much. Yeah, not that much. 300 per credit. If you have 3 credit, that means 300 times 3. So that will be the cost of your subject. Okay, say for example that you are going to study oceanography. Oceanography is 3 credit subject. So 3 credit times oceanography is 3 credit subject and it's a core subject. So if it is a core subject, that means the rate for every credit is not going to be 300, it will be more. Yeah, maybe 500. Yeah, 500. Yeah, that is my estimate lah. Yeah, 500 you times by 3, that means per subject is 1500. Okay, per subject is 1500. So if you repeat that subject, if you fail that subject, then see how much you have to pay to the university. 1500 ringgit is not a small amount of money. Yeah? So please make sure that you study hard and apa lulus, lulus cemerlang ya. Okay. Okay, if let's say during satu semester, during the semester after week 6 or week 5 and above, week 5 and above, you want to withdraw your subject. Withdraw mean you want to stop study this subject. You only want to take several other subject. But this subject I want to withdraw. Yeah, I don't want to take this subject. So if let's say you do that after week 5, after week 4, you'll be charged. Yeah, you will be charged seperti mana repeat paper. Yeah, so jangan withdraw, make a wise decision. If you want to take that subject, ambillah betul-betul subject tu, then study lah. Kalau if you cannot carry the subject, make make sure that you do it before week. Okay, if you withdraw before week 4, tak ada charge. Okay, and then if you want, okay, the third one tu, if let's say, okay, sem 1, you have studied, you you got A for all your subject, and then come to sem sem 2, your subject is only you get C, then you upset about it and you want to improve your grade. You apply to Puan Arena just now that you want to improve my grade, then that will also be charged. I think not much. I think sama. Sama juga macam repeat. Cik Syaful bagi tahu just now. So if you want to improve your grade subject, the charge will be similar atau sama dengan repeat charges for subject. Okay, so if you drop, drop, what is the difference between a drop and withdraw? What is the difference? Drop means you apa ni, withdraw before week 4. So kita panggil drop lah. Kalau after week 4, that means week 5 and above, kita panggil withdraw. Kalau sebelum week 5 tu, makna 4 and below, kita panggil drop. Okay, boleh faham ke? Is it too complicated my explanation? Okay semua? Okay, Rauf, so I can, you faham ya? You understand ya what I'm saying? Okay, okay, let me continue. Okay. Okay, this is total. Okay, next. This slide is about total credit to graduates, the number of credit for BMO, because you know I'm teaching BMO student previously, so I know more about BMO punya ni lah, total credit to graduate. So that normally for BMO is for BMO or I think and any other program, BMO is 121 credit to graduate. So that mean if you want to complete the program, you need to study 121. You need to cover all the 121 credits. That mean subject ocean, subject ni campur-campur semua, add all together, it will apa ni, come to 121. But for other engineering, BET, Bachelor of Engineering Technology subject like BNASB, offshore, I think the total credit to graduate is 142 something like that. Yeah, so your fee, I give you the example of BMO is 56,000 it will be divided to all these total credit to graduate, yeah, based on the category of subject lah. Yeah, bila madam kata category of subject, that means either it's UniKL subject, core subject, or MQA subject. Yeah, there are three types of subject yang you all akan belajar, ya. UniKL subject, MQA subject and core subject. Normally core subject will start with L, if I'm not mistaken, ya. Okay, so this is the how to calculate, ya. If you can refer to this lah if you want to calculate the TCG, you can refer to this. Okay. Okay. For those student, okay. For those student from UniKL MIMED, yeah. Okay, you will be considered as alumni. Yeah, if you take diploma before, then you continue degree at UniKL MIMED, you will get a discount 5%, yeah. So please contact finance lah if you the alumni of MIMED diploma, if you have you are diploma holder of UniKL MIMED, then you will get 5%, or any other UniKL, right? Kan, Cik Shaful. Okay, bukan UniKL MIMED saja, UniKL MIMED lain pun boleh entitled for 5% discount. Okay, or maybe your parents your parents are also working with UniKL, you can also get the discount lah. Okay. Okay, early bird means if you pay early, you get discount lah, yeah, 250 per semester. Okay, criteria, you have to pay full fees within 30 days from the date registration. Normally this one ni kalau self-sponsored student, yeah, self-sponsored student or international student, kan? International student not entitled, sorry. Okay, for self-sponsored student, meaning that you are sponsored by your parents, yeah. Tak ada PTPTN and tak ada any other sponsor lah, MARA, tak disponsor oleh MARA, tak disponsor oleh PTPTN or yayasan negeri. Yeah, jadi if you pay full before within 30 days from the date of registration, you'll get a discount of 250 ringgit, sorry, eh, bukan 250,000, sorry, ya. Eh. Okay, next. Okay, this is the example, eh. So the tuition fee is not the correct, I mean not the actual tuition fee at UniKL MIMED. This is just for example of calculation. Okay, you can refer to this if you entitled to get a discount. Okay, next, for those sponsored and self paying student, yang madam kata tadi, selain daripada MARA, PTPTN and also yayasan, you can you all boleh bayar secara installment. Okay, you can pay via installment payment. You can ask for installment payment, but you have to pay within that semester. You have to complete the installment during the semester, during the current semester that you study. Okay, say for example that now sem 1 selalunya if you are in sem 1, you can apply, kalau you all tak ada bercadang, you don't have any intention to apply for MARA or PTPTN or yayasan, you can apply for installment payment now from finance department. You can email to us and get the installment payment. During registration, you can only you can only pay 40%, and then second installment you can either choose whether to pay 60%, perhabis kan, just finish all the fee outstanding for that, for this same one, or the second option, 40 during the registration, second installment 30%, and third installment 30%. So all this will be incorporated in surat aku janji. Yeah, there's a letter, sort of a letter of undertaking for you to fill in. Yeah, based on that 40-30-30. Yeah, the system will take up the installment payment and bill you according to your installment. So normally by the third installment is the time when it is about just before your, a few weeks before your final exam. So make sure that you pay before as early as possible lah. When it comes to the third installment, try to pay as early as possible. Yeah, because we don't want to avoid from you not being barred from taking the exam, final exam. Okay, faham ke? Okay, so those, okay, siapakah? Okay, next slide ya, next slide dah. Siapakah yang tidak layak penajaan MARA ataupun PTPTN ya? Okay, orang, okay, untuk melayakkan anda, okay, saya bercakap dalam, saya bertukar kepada bahasa Malaysia ya, because the slide is in BM, so saya bertukar kepada BM ya. Okey, kelayakan, siapakah yang tidak layak ya untuk memohon MARA, mestilah CGPA 2.5 ke atas. Maknanya kalau anak-anak semua daripada STPM ke ataupun diploma, you punya your CGPA at your previous college tu mestilah 2.5 ke atas. Then you entitled lah untuk mendapat penajaan MARA. Ya. Yeah? Tapi sekiranya kata kurang 2.5, kenalah buat rayuan lah, kita cuba ya. Yeah? Yang bagi rezeki adalah yang atas ya, Allah. Okay. So mana tahu dapat. Okay. Yang then pencapaian akademik. Sekiranya, then kalaulah kata dah dapat, kalau dah dapat penajaan MARA atau PTPTN, make sure you punya result jangan rendah, jangan below 2.0. Kalau PTPTN, if your result is less than 2.0, dia akan tarik balik penajaan. Okay, kalau MARA akan tarik balik penajaan sekiranya kurang daripada 2.5 bagi 2 semester berturut-turut. Maknanya you have to make sure that your result is more than 2.5. Kalau boleh, madam doakan semua yang ada dalam line, dalam teams ni dapat 3 and above semua for all semester ni. Madam doa sekarang, okay, semua dapat 3.0 and above. Kalau boleh dapat, cuba dapatkan dean's list setiap semester, because itu bagus untuk peluang kerja you esok-esok ya. Okey, tempoh tajaan. Okey, tempoh tajaan, yuran pengajian di luar tempoh penajaan MARA PTPTN perlu dibayar kalau sekiranya ni madam maksudkan ni MARA dan PTPTN ni dia ada tempoh tajaan tau. Kalau you dapat, dia kata 3 tahun. Ataupun 4 tahun ataupun 3 tahun setengah untuk degree, MARA akan bagi sama ada 3 tahun setengah untuk BMO Dan untuk BET, Bachelor of Engineering Technology yang lain tu, Mara akan bagi selalunya 4 tahun. Okey, maknanya 8 semester. So sekiranya anda, anak-anak semua ni extend your study to 10 semester ataupun 9 semester, that 9 and 10 will not be covered by MARA or PTPTN. Maknanya dia akan cover setakat you belajar tu lah. Okay. Sama juga kalau lah, sebab tu you kena make sure study tu kena plan betul-betul. Ya, jangan ada, jangan defer study, sebab once you defer, you automatically extend your apa ni, total your study in UniKL, in UniKL MIMET lah ya. Kalau you defer, of course you supposed to finish in 4 years, but you have to finish it in 4.5 years. Yeah, so make sure that you get the right way to study. Carilah jalan cara belajar yang efficient. Yeah, yang efficient. Yeah, so boleh inilah cuba tanya dengan pensyarah-pensyarah ya, cara belajar yang terbaik ya. Especially online kan. Okay. Okay, sekiranya okay, yang last one tu, penangguhan pengajian. Ya, setiap penangguhan pengajian, penukaran kursus pengajian perlu mendapat kebenaran kelulusan bertulis dari MARA PTPTN terlebih dahulu. So kalau you all nak tukar kursus, you dah belajar 1 sen, tiba-tiba nak tukar kursus, mesti kena dapat approval from MARA atau PTPTN. Ya, yeah. Okay. And then samalah. Ya, yeah, kalau you tangguh pengajian seperti yang tadi madam kata, defer kan. Kalau you all defer tu, dia akan menangguhkan, tak, yang kalau defer tu tak perlu mendapat MARA punya kelulusan, tetapi dia akan extend your study. Okay? Okay, faham ya semua? Can we go to the next slide? Okay. Okay, ini berkenaan dengan, okay, next slide is deferment payment. Eh, surat deferment payment ni maknanya you katakanlah tadi madam dah explain yang berkenaan dengan those self-sponsored student, kan? Dia nak bayar by installment, so dia dia akan must fill in the surat aku janji. Surat aku janji tu mesti ditandatangani oleh pelajar dan juga ibu bapa kena. Ibu bapa, ya. Yeah. Okay. Okay, student boleh apply. Student can apply surat aku janji through finance counter for those who will be in the campus or via online, ya. Yeah. And must adhere to the installment. Maknanya you have to make sure that you pay according to the installment that you have agreed, yeah, in your surat aku janji. Okay, then student whom breach the installment payment must make full settlement for outstanding fees immediately. Meaning that before, that will be before your final exam. You must make sure that your installment payment being paid. Ini selalunya berlaku sama ada to those yang financed by parents, or kalau yang ada repeat papers. Yeah, those yang with repeat papers, normally they will come to finance counter and ask for surat aku janji. Because one subject, if it is cost for 1,500, of course UniKL MIMET will give you discount, yeah, for the repeat papers. But still, it's money, kan? Duit. So buat apa kita buang duit macam tu saja, kan? So might as well kita make sure that all the subject kita pass lah. Okay. Di UniKL MIMET, we have ada satu condition right after you receive your result. Okay, so katakanlah one of your, you fail one of the subject, you can straight away ask for receipt. Bukan repeat ya, receipt. That mean within certain, right after you receive apa your result tu, terus call Puan Arena, Department Puan Arena tadi, ask for receipt. Receipt mean you duduk balik dalam exam, you sit for the exam again, yeah, the same subject that you fail. Sit for that exam again a few weeks after you receive your result. Okay, yang itu you tak, then you tak payahlah. You, that will avoid you from from ditukar menjadi pelajar yang ada subjek repeat. Nanya avoid you jadi repeat lah, kena repeat subjek lah. You just receipt subjek tu, maknanya dah dapat exam tu, call Puan Arena punya department, staff Puan Arena kata saya nak receipt for that subject. Then a few weeks after that, you will be called to come to, ataupun you will be asked to come to do the exam in online exam. Dan terus, maybe your status will change from repeat to pass. Okay? Okay, ada soalan? Ada nampak soalan sebab sini, skrin ni tak nampak soalan. Okay, next. Paring, ya. Okay, madam tak suka ni. This slide ni madam sangat tak suka. But I have to show you, ya. I don't like this slide. Okay, student with outstanding will be barred from examination. Okay. Okay, kalau for those student who will be barred from taking exam, finance department will SMS you all, will SMS to your number, make sure that, and will be reminded, the student will be reminded lah about the outstanding, and then we also will send to your parents lah if we need to, reminder untuk your outstanding, kalau you tak ada outstanding, tak ada, you will not be receive all this thing. Okay, so you cannot access to ECT, because once you will be barred, you cannot access to ECT. You tak boleh tengok your result, you cannot see, you cannot print out your exam slip, kan? At now online macam mana, ya? You tak boleh access to ECT lah at all. So kalau you tak boleh access ECT, how are you going to get your access to your exam, soalan exam, and then you cannot register for next semester, for the following semester you cannot register, register study lah, continue study for your following semester lah. And you cannot stay, stay in a hostel, you will be blocked to stay in a hostel, and then kalau lah kata you dah graduate but you still have your outstanding payment, your name will be advertised at the newspaper, and then legal action. Okay, this one you all jangan takut, you all jangan takut. Kalau you all study cantik-cantik, your result will be tremendously scored, your result will be very very good, 3.0 and above for all semester, so you will not be receiving all this, you all akan belajar dengan tenang, pergi kelas pun dengan tenang, finance tidak akan kacau you all. Dia tak akan kacau, dia tak akan buat apa. So you all study secara tenang, okay. So next punya ni, next slide. That slide berkenaan dengan refund. Ya, selalu refund untuk yang withdrawal. Ya, withdrawal ni maknanya withdrawal daripada belajar di Uni KL, MIMET. Okay. Dan juga untuk yang dah habis belajar, completed. When you have completed your study, okay, say for example, 3.5, 7 semester, you dah habis belajar. Dan for apapun 8 semester, you dah habis belajar, you graduated. So we will refund some of your deposit, semua tu kita akan refund. Ya, yeah? Tapi kena habis dululah belajar baru kita refund. Ya. Yeah? Okay. Okay, apakah yang refundable fee tu? Ya. Yeah? Okay, yang sekiranya tuition fee tu you all terbayar lebih. Katalah you all dah bayar semester 2 tiba kita you all dah bayar. Pada semester 2 dah bayar full. Tiba-tiba in the middle of the semester you want to withdraw from your study. We will refund. Yeah, the according to jumlah subjek yang you belajar, kita akan prorate based on week yang you pergi kelas, macam tu. Kita akan buat pengiraan. Okay. Okay, other yang non-refundable, there are other fees that non-refundable. Non-refundable deposit pun kita student deposit kita akan refund, ya. Deposit yang 250 kita akan refund bila you all dah habis belajar. For international student security bond, ya, yeah, we will refund to you after you have completed your study. Okay. And then the process for refund, student is required to fill in and submit completed clearance slip. So this will be emailed to you. Okay. And then those yang kalau we cannot identify the refund, ya, we will have to submit the money that we cannot identify to Jabatan Akaunten Negara. We cannot keep it in Uni KL. Eh? So that money kalau kita simpan di Uni KL adalah salah. Ya, kita kena transfer that money to Jabatan Akaunten Negara. Okay, for you, just for your information. Ya. Okay, payment. How are you going to make payment? Okay, you can make payment through CIMB Click and also JomPay. Okay, so dah biasa, you all biasa dengan CIMB Click and JomPay. Okay, kalau you all ada bank account CIMB, it will be better. Eh, it will be easier for you. Eh. If not, you can use JomPay. Okay. 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 If you use JomPay, there is question. Yeah. There is a question by JomPay that you need to fill in. And there's a information that you need to fill in, which is bila code. Yeah, Uni KL. So bila code for Uni KL MIMET is 94953. So you fill in here. So at this corner here, reference one, you just put student ID number, your student ID number, but you have to start with F. Katalah your student ID number, say for example that your student ID is, normally student ID start with what? 5 numbers, eh? 2 something, 2 2 3 1 0 something, eh? Like that. But in the beginning of the that number, you have to put F. Jadi F2028, something like that lah. Okay, okay. So understand, everybody boleh faham ke? Reference tu pun also you put the same thing lah. Yeah, so you have to put it twice. Yeah, reference one and reference J, just put in your ID number, but with F in front. Okay. Okay, this is our contact number. Office, you can call this. number 05690-9041. General line 05690-9000. If you call general line, you have to ask from the receptionist that you want to speak to finance department. So they will transfer the line to finance department. Okay. So you can WhatsApp to this number 011-2075-3500. Okay. So WhatsApp your problems, whatever outstanding, or you have made payment. For example, you have made payment. You have gone through your ledger and there's the outstanding bill and you want to make payment and you have made the payment. Okay, snap, you screenshot your payment. Screenshot your payment and WhatsApp the picture, the screenshot picture to that number. Yeah, to WhatsApp to, or if you don't want to WhatsApp your payment to this number, you can also email to this email address finance.mimet@unikl.edu.my, or you can CC your payment to me. Yeah? My name, this is my name and my email address, nikumaimah@unikl.edu.my. You can email to Nick Umaimah ataupun you CC to the Umaimah, email to finance.mimet, CC to me. Okay? Then, okay, and if you have any inquiry about your fee or whatever, you can also email to me. Then I will forward to finance department lah. Yeah, to advise, to give you the advice, the right advice. Because sometimes, if I do not know the details, I will have to ask finance department to assist me in answering your problems. Okay. 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 If you want to go through my upper slide. There's the last three part is question and answer that normally student will ask. Yeah, I'm not going to explain to you the detail here, the question and answer, but you can go through. Okay. But I just want to remind you on the ni lah, the best time. Ha, yang ini penting. When is the best time to pay tuition fee? During or after the registration? Yeah. Full payment for tuition fee must be made before semester examination begin. Maknanya yang tadilah Maiden duk explain to you a few times before. Yeah. So this is yang Maiden mahu nak tekankan lah. Okay. So you can go through the question and answer in the slide that I think I have in this EWOW, so you can go through. Okay, this one question and answer. Okay, on PTPTN lah, tuition fee, EPF withdrawal. Okay, if your parents contribute to EPF, you can use EPF to pay for your tuition fee or what for other fee lah, yeah. Your parents can use their EPF for tuition fee, to pay your tuition fee. Because untuk yang those yang PTPTN, PTPTN yang dapat PTPTN, PTPTN will not cover 100% of the tuition fee. Yeah, just to remind you all, PTPTN hanya I think the most is 80%, kan? Ada tak yang 100%? Ikut income parents. Yes, okay. Cik Syafu kata ikut income parents, ya. Yeah. Maybe ada lah yang 100%, ya. Yeah. Tapi ada kalau income parents tinggi, then the PTPTN will not cover 100%. the normally they will cover only 80%, 70%. So those yang 30% or 20% yang PTPTN tak cover tu will be self-sponsored. Maknanya you all kena top up. Faham tak? Kalau kata satu semester, you all punya fee will be charged not according to TCG. Untuk setiap semester tu dia punya fee tu tak ada, kita tidak charge according to TCG because it will be figure dia akan berbeza setiap semester, ya. So kita akan charge, kita akan bahagikan jumlah total fee kepada jumlah semester. Contoh BMO the fee is 56,000. We will divide with 7 semester because BMO they will only study, they will complete their study for in 7 semester. So kalau 56,000 divided with 7 semester, that mean per semester you have to pay 8,000. Katakanlah that 8,000 tu PTPTN hanya cover 80%. Yeah, so 80% of 8,000 means berapa, ya? Encik Syahu. So the other 20% will have to be top up by kalau by you lah, ya. Yeah. Kalau 8,000, 80% is 6,400, kan? So yang the other 20% bersamaan dengan jumlah 1,600 will have to be paid by you. So you have to pay it during that semester. Okay, faham ya? Kalau MARA normally they will cover 100% lah, ya. Yeah? Melainkan kalau tak dapat MARA lah, ya. Yeah? Then you have to apply for PTPTN. Okay. Okay, this is the question for refund. So you can read through. Good, that's all for my presentation ataupun briefing untuk finance. I wish you all the best in your study. Thank you for joining UniKL MIMET. I think you have made the right decision for joining MIMET, because this is the right time for you to continue to pursue your study in degree. Because you know that economic condition is not good, so it's very difficult to find a job, then this is the time for you to study. Yeah, continue your study. So by the time you graduated from your study, you'll be able to find a good job. Yeah, job. Kita punya ekonomi dia ada musim dia tinggi rendah. So ini the starting of economic downturn. I think it has already started a few years back. I think last year. So dia dah sampai to when it come to the peaks, dan kita ekonomi kita akan naik balik. Dia macam tu. Ekonomi dia ada naik turun, every 5 years dia turun, lepas tu dia naik, dia boom. Masa tu semua orang akan cari pekerja. Semua most organisation will search for the graduates. Okay. Tapi so far daripada apa yang madam dapat tahu, most of our alumni yang baru graduated ni pun dah ada yang dapat kerja, ya. Rezeki dia orang. Okay. Okay, so any question? You all ada dengan saya ke lagi? Rauf? You with me? Syafiq? Okay, Muhammad Syafiq. Faham ya, ada any question that yang boleh tanya? Ada nak tanya apa-apa ke? Okay, thank you Rauf. You understand ya, Rauf? Boleh you the apa kita punya explanation? Faham ya? Okay. Because most of you have studied before in your college, kan? So almost macam itulah. Samalah, ya. So kalau you only diploma, you all fresh from school, so lainlah sikit ya. Tapi kalau you only from college, so almost the same cara billing ya. Belajar ya. So you all sepatutnya boleh tahulah, faham, senanglah. So madam, kalau ada apa, ada apa-apa question? Kalau tak ada, kita boleh tamatkan apa finance briefing. Madam nak ucapkan I wish you all the best. You all, how many of you here? I think more than 10 eh. Cik Adam ya. So I wish you all will get 3.5 and above semua eh. So you all will be a top scorer. Yang intake ni, intake yang dalam tu ada dengan madam ni semua ni, madam doakan will be top scorer. Ya, amin. Kita semua akan jadi top scorer. Okay. So dean's list every semester. Ya, yeah, madam doakan semua dean's list every semester. Ya. Yeah. Okay. Okay, thank you very much. Wish you all the best. Yeah, thank you for joining UniKL MIMED. Okay, bye. Assalamualaikum.
Okey, Puan Nik, terima kasih untuk sesi kita pada sebelah pagi. So, kita dah selesai tiga sesi lah. Maknanya sesi keselamatan, academic briefing dan juga finance briefing. Okey, semua boleh berehat dulu. Terusnya pada pukul 2.30 nanti. 2.30 nanti kita buat akan sambung semula sesi EWOW ni untuk tiga lagi sesi penting, iaitu berkenaan dengan pinjaman, e-learning dan juga library. Okay, so boleh berehat dulu. 2.30 nanti kita berjumpa semula. Okay, kalau ada apa-apa nak tanya, kita boleh tanya, pelajar boleh tanya dalam grup grup WhatsApp tadi, grup WhatsApp yang dah ada, semua dah ada dalam tu, boleh tanya juga dalam tu. Okay.